Shalom, shalom, it's the brother Kadash. I'm going to start off by giving
and now we're turning to this.
All praises to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem, Rekakadash. Double honors to all the brothers in the truth. Peace, blessings, honors to the apostles of Great Millstone. This is a federal judge got killed in a hit and run. But the reason why this is important, because this is showing the times that we're in. This is showing that we're in the end times when you're starting to see this judgment go out. You know, because these things don't just happen for no reason. Anybody that dies on earth, it's because the Lord, you know, it was their time. The Lord chose that time for it to be their time, you know. So nothing happens without the say-so from the Lord, you know. So seeing this happen shows us that, okay, these people are starting to get the curses put on them, and they're starting to get judged too. And that judgment is starting to come down because, you know, a lot of these federal judges have done a lot of wickedness, you know, and unrighteous things. And the Lord is starting to bring that judgment down on them. This is 2 Esdras chapter 9, verse 1. It says, he answered me then and said, measure thou the time diligently in itself. So we measuring the time. No man knows the day that the Lord is going to come back, because the Lord is going to come back like a thief in the night, right? But we still measuring the time diligently and seeing, okay, it's getting close to that time. The Lord said we know the seasons, right? There'll be signs. It says, and which I have told thee before, then shalt thou understand that it is the very same time wherein the highest will begin to visit the world which he made. So the Lord is starting to visit the earth that he made, man. Therefore, when there shall be seen earthquakes and uproars of the people in the world. So what are we seeing? You know, we've seen earthquakes all in California, all in different islands. There was just a volcano. You know, what goes with a volcano eruption? Earthquakes. You know, we just seen that. And, you know, they were saying people that got the jab was being the only people rescued. You know, that's the crazy thing about it. But we've seen uproars of the people in the world. You know, all 50 states, really all over the world, there was uproars of the people, especially with the whole George Floyd thing. Now, if they acquit this police officer, well, y'all know what's going to happen, man. You better be ready. It says, then shall thou well understand that the Most High spake of these things from the days that were before thee, even from the beginning. For like as all that is made in the world has a beginning and the end is manifest. So everything has ended. You know, Egypt was the greatest kingdom on earth at a point in time. It ended. You know, Persian Medes, Babylonians, you know, in no order, but the Greeks, the Greek Empire, you had the Roman Empire. All these was like the greatest kingdoms on earth, but they all came to an end. So just like America, which is Mystery Babylon in the Bible, Revelations 18 and 17, it's also going to come to an end. It says, even so, the times also, the highest have plain beginnings and wonders and powerful works and the endings and effects and signs. And that's what it's about. These are the signs right here. But this verse 7 is the point. And everyone that shall be saved and shall be able to escape by his works and by faith whereby ye have believed. So works and faith goes together. You read about that in James chapter 2. So you got to have faith, but you got to have works to justify your faith. You know, so it goes together. So people say, well, why are we talking about certain topics and stuff that happen? Because that's us doing the work. So let's look at this play.
The woman is charged in a deadly hit and run crash. This is in Boca Raton, and the victim has been identified as a federal judge from New York. Authorities say 23-year-old Natasha Snape drove around, stopped a traffic. This is on North Ocean Boulevard Friday night, hitting a woman and a 6-year-old boy. The boy was seriously injured, rather. And according to the New York Post, the woman killed was federal judge Sandra Furstein, who was from Long Island, that area there. Police say Snape claimed to be Harry Potter after she drove away from that scene and crashed her car. She's facing several charges, including vehicular homicide.
Keep that right there. So this right here is the federal judge and the same hit and run. That's how the federal judge looks. So hey, but this is Job chapter 4 verse 7. It says, remember, I pray thee, whoever perished being innocent, or where were the righteous cut off? You know, so whoever perished being innocent, meaning that if a person did perish by something like this, they weren't innocent. You know, they sinned in some type of way, and it was their time to go, you know, so That just is what it is. So that's why we go so hard and saying, look, you have to repent. Because look, same thing with the Kid Cudi thing. Us getting on him, telling him he needs to repent, that's showing him love. Because we're trying to save him from that destruction that the Lord going to bring down on him, that judgment that the Lord is going to bring down on him. So we really showing him more love than the people telling him to do whatever he wants to. The people telling you to do whatever you want to don't really love you. Because when the Lord comes down and judge you, then they ain't going to be able to do nothing about it. You know, but we trying to warn you. We trying to warn you and tell you to repent We trying to tell you to repent, like you said when I was just in 2nd Esdras chapter 9, verse 7, everyone that shall be saved shall be able to escape by his works and by his faith whereby ye have believed. So you have to believe in this, and you have to have works, meaning you got to do the right thing, keeping the law, statutes, commandments to the best of your ability, and you got to have faith in the Lord. And if you got faith in the Lord, then you're going to do the works anyways. So that's why we're trying to rebuke him so he can repent, so he won't be judged. It's not too late, you know. But with that, I'm going to say salvation to the elect. Shalom.